Right, hello everybody, welcome to the SFL final between Scuromezzo and Calcium. I'm Jimmy Fantastic. With me in the booth is Squirrel Dude, who is the like runner of the league. Is that correct to say?
I am an admin. Really, Extra Arms Bot does all the real work in SFL, like setting the schedule and telling people when to play and managing the records. So, EAB once again the true hero.
Glorious.
The Shawnee Football League here with the Shit Hair Bowl 5.
Oh, you shouldn't have said that. It's SHT Bowl, where YouTube friendly. SHT, yeah, so yeah.
The Shice Bowl 5, whatever.
Something. So yeah, it's interesting. So they start at like about 1300 TV, is that correct? Something like that.
Yes. 1300 team value. I believe these are both drafted teams, so they got a set of skills and 1100 to spend on players.
Yeah, so it, you know, and piling on is banned. That's why there's no piling on the whites. I mean, might not have taken anyway. And wizards are not allowed either. Scuro has got two bribes for this, and he does have a dirty player, zombie, and 13 players. So he could get quite murdery. Calcium will, of course, be happy there's no piling on against him, but will be sad to not have the wizard, which I guess he would have just bought the wizard, wouldn't he, out of his own money, and given Skuro the money. Because Skuro could have got the wizard, so Calcium would have definitely put in his own money for a wizard, I'm sure.
Yes, that seems reasonable. This is also likely to be Calcium's last game with the team, so he doesn't care about survival. He is going to 100% be in, all in on winning the game. So, one elf is enough.
I hate this move here. Yeah, handover.
Are we seeing a pass to advance the ball up the field already?
Yeah, maybe.
Calcium is incredibly aggressive with his elves. The few times I've seen him actually got around to watching him play, we've seen a lot of 3+ leap-ins hit the cage, a lot of early scores, like full Anarian strats with his ult.
Yeah, so that's why I did it. He was going for the pass. No, he's not. Getting it forward. I don't know, I think I'd rather done a pass, to be honest. Like, you know, and then got the ball on another catcher or something rather than doing that, but fair enough. I don't see Luva, but I did see him. Two block mummies, yeah. They got one of the mummies from, like, they got doubles to build their team. So one of the blocks was the doubles, and the other one he just randomly rolled. But yeah, two block mummies is very nice, isn't it? And, oh, Luva. Yeah, he will manage without panning. Hello,
yeah, both at the start of the season, both teams were given 200 team value effectively in skills, so upwards of two doubles, though I think most coaches tended towards going one for more, either going one, two, or none. So maybe Skuro got one and it died, I don't know.
You'd have taken two block mummies, wouldn't you, surely?
Yes, yeah.
Surely. And conversely, the doubles for Calcium, I would have put, like, Mighty Blow on a Dancer, which has probably died.
yes, it, in fact...
It was Jimmy Fantastic, Jimmy, wasn't it?
It was Jimmy, and, yeah, and McNaughton killed it. McNaughton killed it, yeah. I think the other one went on the tree with Block.
Sorry, Calcium. Oh dear. Yeah, he's taking a long time to sidestep. I don't really like the assist from the dirty player, because he could have threatened a foul, couldn't he? Squirrel Dude being savage. Holy shit. It depends whether you have a nice community or not, which with Lupak, we all know the answer to that one. And I don't mean that badly, but, you know, it's just there is some bollocks earlier.
That is true. J5 did split an entire Amazon team with a single word answer.
Yep, he sure did. You can't really hit this school, can you? Like the good one, you can hit the kind of crap one, but then that puts him out. Oh, it does hit him. I don't like this stall, this seems very dodgy.
I would have expected to score here considering the setup on the previous turn, but it's only agility 3 ghouls, and ghouls have never done anything to let the undead just randomly win games. Or I guess, you know, the opposite of that. But in reality, I mean, obviously, I think it's probably fine, because Calcium, if he gets the ball knocked down, there isn't really any real recovery, and Calcium has 7 million players that can recover the ball and score.
Yeah, true, true. So. He's massively outnumbering him in this quarter of the field. Quarter of the half. Quarter of the field? Yeah, no, quarter of the half. 3, 6, 8 versus 3, so yeah, he's pretty safe.
1/8 of the field.
Oh, well, sorry, Fliggy Flag. I saw it, so I did it. Do you know what, Fliggy Flag? What can I say? Except, I'm sick of this fucking guy all fucking game with a fucking dice! Fuck off! Oh, God, I need... It's the best thing ever. If you haven't seen that clip of Flicky Flag, you should see that clip of Flicky Flag. Fuck! Oh, it's so good.
YouTube friendly stream here, everybody.
yeah. Fuck's okay. But it's also okay to say shit after the opening, like, about 2 or 3 minutes. So, it's just not in the title or in the first couple of minutes, you're not allowed to say shit. So, on YouTube, this will just be the SFL final. It is stolen content as well, yeah.
Glad I can consistently come on here and accidentally get Jim demonetized and have him lose all of his 2 cents.
Yeah, that's the thing. That's also a thing. Like, the demonetization doesn't really matter, but... I'd rather not get, you know...
I think last time I did a Hulk Hogan impression, and that was the problem. And for those who don't know why a Hulk Hogan impression might be a problem, I'm not repeating it.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Squirrel.
Let's just say the people who don't understand it are in the minority. But,
Oh, no! Squirrel, don't! Don't say anything! Oh, dear. Well, none of that's a piss take or being lovely, but thank you, Flicky. Exactly, yeah, Jim. I mean, not really full Nazi, but, you know, it's fair enough, isn't it? It's their show, so if they want you to not use certain words, that's fair enough. I'm just disappointed that they deem my favourite word on the same level as the words that it shouldn't be on the same level as, in my opinion. There you go. Seems I can't say the words, you know. It's really stupid, in my opinion.
Aggressive one dice there by Skuro, re-rolling it too. I mean, he pins to the sideline, but with sidestep, which I guess is nice.
Yeah, that was pretty aggro. But I mean, and he hasn't got tackle handy, has he?
Calcium does. He can bring his tackle around, I think, and hit. Though he is currently based on tackle.
Yeah,
I guess it will be a GFI.
Dodging a GFI, yeah.
and Calcium can't have anything to fail, otherwise it is going to be a one dice, possibly even a pretty clear two dice surf to get the ball off the field.
Yeah, I guess actually a dodge and a GFI isn't that bad, but he can't hit there and he can't hit there. Like, he couldn't hit either block tackle ghoul out of the way very easily, could he? Needs guard in his team. He could have taken a guard catcher, maybe.
I mean, he's got that tree with guard, and the tree is always good at getting and staying in position when you run all the way up the field very quickly. So.
Yeah.
Has to reroll because of sidestep.
Yep. He gets the pow and kills the ghoul. All you have to do is blitz the ghouls and kill them. I read that on Reddit.
It's about as good as killing all skinks, though not quite as good because they don't have stunty and are strength 3, so, you know.
No apple, though, isn't it? No apple, which is nice. Like, to be fair, I do target ghouls whenever
to be
I can,
fair,
but that's mostly just like ghouls are game winners.
To be fair, I don't think I've ever seen anyone apple with skink either, so it's about the same.
I've seen skinks apple. There was one on a dwarf team on Fumble that was a movement 9 and edge 4 on a dwarf team. Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
And,
yes.
and like other ones, like, you know, super skinks get apple, don't they?
Yes.
But you do need movement 9 edge 4 one or something.
Yeah, the movement 9 one, the edge 4 one, I guess the strength 3 one if you're really greedy and want to try and get like strength 3 sidestep and then hope, I guess, for doubles for block and things.
Strength 4 one, there was a strength 4 one on Fumble as well, which it was quite fun.
That actually seems kind of terrifying.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
3 pluses and 2 dice every ball carrier, no matter what. It's going to get there. Because that's what Lizardmen need.
Yeah. Why would any sane person rank words? Well, fucking Johnny, you jerk. Oh, dear. Right, so there you go. So there was a quick score from Calcium, and now he's only got 2 rerolls left, which isn't ideal, is it? You'd have much preferred to have only had to use 1 reroll on that offense. If any. Scuro's only got 2. He does have a sure hands, but doesn't have edge 4. He's got a fair bit of guard, hasn't he? It's going to be tricky for Calcium, actually, here. Really, it's going to be tricky here. He could have done, yeah, I'm surprised he didn't just score on turn 2, honestly. After the setup on turn 1, I expect him to just score. Like, he didn't really get a lot out of the turn of stall, but he does get a blitz here.
Kicks on the right side of the field as well, because the kick skill might have done something. It's pretty hard to tell. Jim, question for you. What do you think of the 2 block tackle ghouls as opposed to maybe either a wrestle tackle or block sidestep?
I only like going wrestle after I've got, like, on the last ghouls. So if I've got 3 ghouls, I'd take 2 block, then a wrestle. If I've got 4 ghouls, I'd take 3 blocks, then a wrestle. So, the fact that Izzy is a rookie, I don't mind it. I mean, if he'd skill, maybe one of these got skilled just before the match, in which case tackle makes obviously ultimate sense. Oh my god, Calcium, that is fucking rowdy as hell.
Well, it's Calcium. Are we really shocked that he's just? I mean, it makes sense if he can win the game on turn 5.
Yeah,
it's pretty good.
Yeah, it does. That was really fucking rowdy, though.
I think particularly maybe in the OT format, he's more pressured to try and get the game over quickly because Skuro has signaled that I am going to foul you every chance I get with the 2 bribes and the million money worth. So,
yeah, to be fair, Skuro does have the inevitability or whatever, so it's pretty scary. It's pretty scary for Calcium.
GFIs to get him, I don't know. So this is like, Do those GFIs do anything? I guess if he gets knocked down, he's still in scoring range. I mean, he had sure feet, right? But
yeah, he had sure feet, so I guess. I guess it just does it just kind of get in the way of the ghouls, right? Especially if it could bounce in his tackle zone even.
It gets him further away. Gets him further away from the white.
I don't like not tagging the white. This this kicker would have been the perfect lad to just tag the white and stop
it. I'd kind of like to tag the zombies with the blood step catcher as well, just because that block is actually kind of odorous for the zombies to take, because it's not likely to get anything, and the sidestep means it can just keep infiltrating onto your side of the field.
Yeah, I mean, once you've gone in like this, it's kind of crazy not to base. I mean, you've got to base the tackler. It's a guard, it's edge 3. It's like, you just have to base him. You absolutely have to. And then, and then you base the zombie as well, and then he's got to dedicate a man to give the... Well, he doesn't actually. But he's got to dedicate a man to give the assist if he wants to hit the lino. Also, this lino's moved 6, and he's done his job. He's already kicked it. I think that was a crazy non-basing guy.
Yeah.
It is still horrific for Scuro, but at least he can mighty blow him, or just not mighty blow him. But he can still move back with these two, can't he? He can move back with these two. He can blitz with him, and he can make a cage. Like, it's still scary for Scuro, but he can actually.
I think we can all recognize that the best skill here is the diving tackle on the block tackle ghoul. Diving tackle really controlling the field right now.
Yep. I mean, it actually is doing something, isn't it, to be fair?
It's actually doing quite a lot, because I think it's, especially against agility 3, 5 plus dodges are really garbage, so.
Oh, that was horrible from Scuro, wasn't it?
He's gone all the way around to reroll it because a push, I don't understand. Maybe he liked both down result better or something from there as opposed to where else he was, but there wasn't too much of a reason with the side stuff.
No, I don't like that.
Maybe that one particular square that, and maybe if the catcher sidesteps into that one particular square, it's really bad. The square the ghoul is in, it sidesteps to that particular square is kind of bad because it still keeps the screen up. I don't know.
Nah, because he rerolled for the pow anyway, so.
Yeah.
No, I think that was just a mistake. The good thing is, as well, to be fair, Calcium rerolling that block there, it was rowdy. But it does make the fight all about the ball. It stops Guru teeing off with his two bribes and his dirty player.
Mm-hmm.
So it does do. It does do a fine job.
I guess it's a bit of a cage corner now, also, where that ghoul is, so it kind of saved him that player in that way.
Yeah, but he just had more movement. If he blitzed, he would have had all the movement in the world to go wherever he wanted, depending on where the sidestep was. But, imagine, though, if that catcher had based that zombie and that liner had based that white, this is so much worse for Scuro this time.
Yeah. I think he has to do this GFI.
Yeah, he probably should GFI, and he should probably foul the catcher as well. With the white.
Maybe he doesn't foul, he just brings he goes to the left of the white with Mighty Blow guard, and then he brings the Mighty Blow tackle white
to
squares.
Oh man, he's got a GFI.
Yeah.
Oh no. No, he had to GFI.
Well, you have to foul here if you're doing this. You've got to foul for this one, because you have two bribes, so you kind of need to do this.
Oh. You just have a GFI anyway, because Calcium can just hit 1D him now, whereas he didn't. GFI, he couldn't have even done that.
I don't know if I even like... I think I don't like doing that dodge, just because that Ward Answer, if it's taking that block, isn't hitting the ball, so it's actually good for you.
Yeah. Yep, that's fair.
Yeah, I think I'm fine just standing up and making the Ward Answer choose if it wants to waste its turn attritioning me and I'm trying to stabilize, but... And if he's stuck on a... And the catcher's gonna run away next turn anyway, so...
Yep.
Yeah. What else all over the backfield? Sidestep in the right square to block the middle of the field.
Sorry, Orange is in GFOP snakes. I mean, you know, like, I'm not saying that you're saying that, but that's a proper, like, Artemis thing to say, isn't it? And also, it's kind of like a mistake that beginners would say of make your opponent roll the dice and stuff, because at the end of the day, you making a 3% play to protect the ball is much better than giving your opponent a 30% play to pop the ball. Isn't it? Like, you know, it's...
Yeah.
You've got to make that GFI there, and then the ball's totally safe.
It's something you see in Blood Bowl that's the opposite of the fallacy people make in real life, where they will make a decision that is an active one that is worse for them rather than being passive.
Yeah.
Right? And in Blood Bowl, people would choose to rather be passive and just hope their opponent fails than be active and trying to prevent it sometimes.
Yeah. So, Calcium actually being restrained here. Just puts the diamond tackle on the ghoul.
It's pretty hard to get the DT off. Yeah. Oh. Not that hard. Now it's hard. With the tackles tied up this way, it's pretty tricky.
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty restrained, actually, from Calcium after the initial... I mean, he was pretty rowdy turn one. He didn't go for the 1D here. And, you know, managed to restrain himself for going for the 1D in the hopes of making it easy the next turn. Very nice. It does sound like the NFL coach is not going for the fourth down. Yeah, that's true. Les joueurs sont tout proches. Le combat paraît inévitable. That's true.
Yeah, Calcium's done good
it as well.
Job. Yeah, I really like what Calcium's done this turn. It's just really solid. Play super solidly, and your opponent has one reroll. They're agility 3. They can't really dodge away from your stuff. It's agility 4. Maybe you wouldn't like this play as much, but I think it's fine. And, like, what happens? Like, what's the worst that Scuro can do this turn? Get to the middle of all of the elves. Cool, yeah. Let's do it again.
Yeah, no, there's not a lot, is there? He's just got to dodge away from down and tackle, I guess. It's probably literally his best play. I mean, he could double GFI with a zombie and chain the cat. Oh no, the cat just got sidestep, so he can't chain his ghoul. He can just punch things. I guess he's just got to fish for a power. He's got to blitz with the. He's got to block the. He's got to fish for a power on this sidestepper first, and then blitz with the. With the tackle white is what he had to do. I'm pretty sure. Oh, he had tackle there anyway. So it was the ghoul, so he had three. Yeah, he had 2D on the catcher, and then he could have blitzed with there. Yeah, it was pretty easy, actually, wasn't it?
The hard part is getting the sidestepper DT off more than getting this. The catcher was pretty easy to remove. It's getting finding a way to get the sidestepper with DT off of you.
Yeah, well, I mean, you can free up, like, if you power with tackle, then that frees the white to blitz him with tackle. But he just didn't.
Though, so I think if he does pow, I think the catcher can just sidestep into a square that blocks that white from getting to that catcher, right? Calcium just sidesteps up, and then that white can't get into that square to blitz the catcher away.
Nah, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
If he does.
Yeah.
Otherwise, he just mighty blow his white, his war dancer. And then foul him, and hope you can somehow win overtime after it being 2-2. Also, he should foul somebody.
He probably should just take random fouls here. He's got a freed up zombie. The zombie's not going to do anything. Just foul this catcher with sure feet or something.
Yeah, I really think you should have fouled with a white, honestly, like with two bribes.
Yeah.
Like, he's massively on the back foot. He's got to try and do something. And if he had made that foul last turn, maybe he would have KO'd him. And then maybe he would have, KO'd him. Or even stunning him. Might have made his mighty blow free to act the next turn. His tackler free to act. So it wasn't just brainless to do.
No, and also, I don't think he's removed an elf yet. And Wood Elves 11 are terrifying. So.
I mean, you can't get 2D on the ball still. That is the thing with Calcium, isn't it? Like, you know, he's got his guards next to the ball, so it's not easy for Calcium to 2D the ball. 2D with tackle, certainly. I mean, he can 2D, actually.
Yeah, there wasn't a tackle. Yeah, he's a dauntless guy that can sneak around and get you a wrestle hit with two dice with just one assist with that catcher.
Yeah.
To do some stuff, but I didn't. It looks like he needed to move the catcher out, but the catcher would have to dodge from tackle to base the ghoul, and then the thrower comes, provides an assist, and the catcher would have dodged through on the right and pushed the ball towards the middle of the field. He wanted to get with a dauntless 2DB.
Yeah, it's just hard. Like the thing is, it's just hard, isn't it? Like that's the thing. Like, yeah, he's got Scuro in a lot of trouble here, but it is hard to get to put the final nail in the coffin. Ah, Undead. Like he definitely keeps the blood stepper on him, doesn't he?
Yeah, I mean, there's not really a way for Scuromezzo to easily get it off. I guess he now has a freed up tackle guy, so maybe he should even base that with like the thrower.
Yes.
So that he doesn't have a freed up tackle guy. If you free up a dirty player, I mean, freeing up a dirty player zombie's a little spooky, but yeah, I think.
I mean, that gives him a dodge with dodge to hit, but it's still either way he's got.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, there's a double one. That was a bad decision.
And so is my cock.
That was a bad decision because it was a double one. Oof. Yeah, because this was a free 2D. Whereas now he's got the dodge to 2D him.
Yeah.
Or even 3D him if he stands up the white first. But, you know, how's he scoring as well? He's out of rerolls. It is really rough for Scuro.
Has Calcium even tried to stand up that tree? Has it just been completely terrible so far?
He might have forgotten about it. He might have, you know, had not perfect ordering and just thought, you know, done it later. I've done that occasionally.
Yeah. He might have been, maybe he was waiting to stand up and see if he could do some GFIs to base something.
Yeah, might maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe double GFI to base the mummy. I think Scuro has to do the ghoul dodge. Oh, he can get the mummy in, yeah. So the ghoul dodge for the 3D.
He can just stand up the white and base this catcher with the ghoul in the back and then blitz with the block tackle for three dice.
Yeah, he's got this block tackler at the back. I was thinking he had fucking got through and he double wanded it. Yeah, of course he's.
That block was a little aggressive because if he gets pushes, he can then tag the block tackle and deny him that player.
Yes, that was wrong. I mean, who's to say what's right or wrong, but I can say that's wrong.
No one cares what you say on stream. You've let Calcium call everyone a cunt his entire broadcast. No one cares.
No, not the C word. That's the bad word.
I said country.
No, you didn't. It's the bad word. Don't say the bad word.
Country.
Don't say it again.
I added a rule at the end.
Right, so he fouls with the ball carrier now, doesn't he? Oh.
I think he should. Maybe he can just use the random ghoul at the back and foul the war dancer.
Oh boy, he's running through or something. He's got no rerolls, so he can't GFI. Yeah, gonna run out. Yeah, I guess he's got to get forward a bit, hasn't he? Oof, he does do the GFI. Urum Skurum. Double GFI from the mummy to make this a 2D? No. I quite like the double GFI mummy. Like, it's a bit stupid, but if it works, you're pretty happy, aren't you?
Unironically, do you send the zombie to go base the tree man so that it can't possibly get into play as you move further up the field?
Yeah, I mean, zombies are the perfect place to do that, aren't they? So I wouldn't hate it at all. A double GFI off the tree could do something.
Yeah, the tree GFIs. Okay, the tree just continues to be terrible.
Yeah, I think he looks like he has been remembering it.
Undead are the are one of the very few teams that can kind of deal with the tree, because they can just block it down, and then this will just happen, where the tree is just worthless for the rest of the game.
Yeah, like, it's minimal effort for them to block it down, isn't it? That's the thing, like, anyone can block it down if they put half the team on it, but it's
going to be put on the OS
anyway as Undead.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, there are ogres that can kind of deal with it. The ogres have Bonehead, and then obviously Kimri can deal with it, and I guess some lizards can in a way. The lizards don't want to, because lizards usually have way too many other problems for their souls to be dealing with.
Yeah. But I mean, anyone can, can't they? Like, that's the thing.
Yeah.
Anyone can. They can just walk, they can lure the LOS, and even the strength 3 team, if depending on the setup, can just put in everybody. But if they do, they probably lose. Whereas it's just minimal effort for Undead. I think they called them Undies, which was a pretty good name.
The ball is based.
Yep, that's an automatic win for Calcium. I feel like Calcium's blown this a bit. I mean, you know, like, he got pressure on, but I feel like he probably should have taken the hit when he had the chance. Because
yeah, maybe there's a turn he should have taken. I think there's a turn where he had, like, the two dice with the catcher with Russell, and maybe he should have taken that hit on the ball. Go for something a bit more aggressive.
Yeah, I think you had to do something, because all the guard, well, maybe if he just tagged that the guard tackler ages ago, you know, maybe that would have been enough.
Yeah.
Because he got those guards in, and it made it very difficult.
Well, Calcium has escaped with some elves down the field, so it's not like Skuro's going to get a free walk-up, and his mummies aren't going to be able to assist, probably. So it's still pretty good. I don't think I like that dog.
Don't know. I mean, this is better than Skuro had any right for it to be.
Yes. The guard carrier also appears to be doing some good work here, providing some free assists that Skuro wouldn't be able to get otherwise.
Indeed, yeah.
Yeah, Skuro, we shit on Skuro. I'm trying to make sure what the bad words are. I just realized.
It's just the one. Don't say the C word, and obviously the N word, and the R word.
I will.
And the F word, but not that F.
Don't say the nut word or the slur words. Got it. Okay. We kind of take the piss on Skuro for being a mediocre coach or a bad coach who has already won a shit hairball and is possibly going to win a second one.
That block.
I don't know what that was for. Mm-hmm. But usually when Skuro loses, it's not because he played bad the entire game, it's because he has one really bad turn and then plays well for the rest of it. That kind of spoils a bunch of good turns. So so far he's played pretty well, but we just took a block with a blockless zombie that didn't seem to do anything. So,
YouTube does, yes, Lupak. If you look at a YouTube video when you upload it, it's extreme profanity is like the N word and the C word. They both count as extreme. So, yeah, they demonetize.
You could be my wingman.
They don't ban it.
Bullshit. You can be mine.
Hello, Chunter. I mean, because obviously, like, you know, there's lots of rap music, isn't it, that has that has that in. But yeah, they put the C word as extreme as the other one, which is crazy to me, but not to YouTube. Thank you very much, Chunter, for the C word. There you go, Chunter with the C word. And thank you very much for the massive raid. Absolutely glorious. Welcome to the SFL final. We can call it the shit hair bowl now that it's after the first couple of minutes.
That may be the dislike of the C word by YouTube may be an American sensibilities thing, where that word is viewed much more harshly than it is in England, as it would appear, apparently.
Yeah.
So...
I tell you what, what's he called? Calcium's been rolling like a badass on his tree, hasn't he? He hasn't been forgetting. He's just been failing every single time.
If you're the person, the kind of person who doesn't like a tree, this is a poster game to show why the tree is a terrible player.
Yeah.
Because sometimes it just isn't an actual player. Sometimes you're playing 9 versus 11 because your tree doesn't do anything. But don't worry, it only cost him 170 team value.
Oh, he only needed the push, but he got the power glorious. He still can technically score, can't he?
With that ghoul 3 GFIs.
3 GFIs he can score.
Undead are fast when they need to be.
You can clear this dancer with a pow. Gets it. Yes, it was the wrong order, yes. Yep, that's true. If he had hit the dancer first and pushed it, he would have been able to clear the other one with a push, and perhaps with a 3 dice as well.
Yeah.
So that was...
It was also the blockless block before the one without block.
I don't think that really matters, because if either fails, he's fucked.
But... Well, no, if he takes the both down, he can take the both down on the war dancer and just get pushes on the sidestep guy, right? On the diving tackle, and then he can do a 3+ dodge away.
I just don't think the both down matters as much. I don't really think it matters. I think the important thing is the first way. If he doesn't this way, he just needs push. And also, if he gets a power, gets 3 dice. And this one is in scoring range, isn't it, already? 3, 6, 9, yep. So this one is in scoring range, and now he's got to make his GFIs to get the other one in. I guess he's got sidestep, so actually, he didn't need to make the second GFI.
Though, I was going to say, now, he's not even in range if he gets knocked down with the sidestep, so no. Second GFI doesn't seem to have much of a point in that case.
Yeah.
Because if it was a situation where sidestep would let him be in range, even if he was knocked down, that would be pretty valuable.
Yeah. Yeah, but the fact that he couldn't get knocked out of range means that he should have left them both to last. I guess this way he can go laterally if he has to.
Yeah.
But I feel like it was more important not to leave the ball on the floor for the elves.
I don't think that makes sense.
It'd been fairly trivial for the score, wouldn't it? Just some 2s and 3s if he'd fallen over there.
I don't know. Okay. So Calcium is going to get the mandatory push downwards, it looks like. The tree is just the worst.
Reminded me of the World Cup, this. Holy shit.
Saving the War Dancer Blitz for last. Okay. It took me a second to realize why Calcium did the no skill dodge before, but now I see kind of why he wanted to do it that way. I think.
Yeah.
Depending on where he wants to blitz from here.
Whoa.
Okay, now I'm a bit confused.
Interesting. The tree did eat the snake eyes. Yeah, okay, that's kind of interesting, isn't it? Because obviously if he hit him, he could have sidestepped somewhere and...
This play now is... I don't see anything better than a minus 2D. No, I guess you can dodge the ghoul out and make it a 1D and do a GFI with the mummy to negate the assist backwards. And the ghoul isn't on tackle, so it's a 3+ with a reroll into a 1 dice blitz with the sidestepper on the guy that doesn't have skills.
No, I think you just dodge two dice blitz with a ghoul and then dodge with a carrier. Isn't it?
Yeah, you dodge around, hit the guy with no skills, hit him, try and hit him down.
Yeah, and if you get the pal, you just hit out of nine and then a GFI. Try and chain him, I guess. There's like you could fish for a pal on this on the sidestepper. In fact, you can three dice the sidestepper.
Well,
probably.
He has a three dice on the catcher, right? He can three dice that catcher with the mummy.
Move the guard in. Move the guard in and three dice the blood stepper. Get him away from the tackler, and the tackler could like do a chain maybe. I don't know, but I would just do the ghoul dodge. Like there's maybe a clever chain to chain your dude forward. But then it would still be a 4 plus 3 plus or whatever, so I think it's definitely best to just dodge.
Yeah, I don't see a way to chain the ghoul forward. I see a chain that, like, moves some players around. I don't think there's a chain to get the ghoul forward in another square. I don't think there's enough players up there to fill in the squares needed to do that. You think you need...
Oh, he just makes an blockless block.
Oh, okay, that's really bad. I don't understand why that happened.
No. I mean, I guess he was trying to free the catcher.
Glorious.
Like, you know,
no, I won't give
the
yeah.
away.
Until so I'm victorious.
Yeah, the zombie
and
is not going to block
it. I will defend.
I think the player was definitely just dodge 2D with a one ghoul and then dodge with the carrier. Thank you very much, Tom Schniz. Thanks for staying fantastic for a year.
I know why we give Skuro shit. I know why we do it. Cool. It's because there are turns where halfway through a turn he'll realize that the space in the middle he thought was big enough for a cage is three squares wide and not five, and so his entire plan falls apart.
Oh, dear. Yeah, it was just that, and that's why I hate bribes, right? Because the bribes are good if the game goes well, but I feel like they don't really help you if it goes wrongly. But then he had the opportunity to use them when it went wrongly. Like, he could have just fouled with his block guard, you know, his guard, mighty blow tackler, could have put in some fouls when he was struggling to stabilize because he had the bribes. So he actually could have used it while it was going badly, like, incredibly, and then just didn't.
Yeah, I think this is a good example of how bribes can't just be used for gang fouls. They should also be used as a way to open up other avenues of play that aren't usually available because the risk is too high. But with two bribes, fouling just random players that are near the ball and of good value is actually usually going to be worthwhile. Just to basically get a free armor roll, it's an armor value 7 player. It's pretty good.
Yeah.
At some point, I should point out that, like, SFL signups are open for, like, next season, and we do a draft and things, but I don't know, there you go. That's all I really need you to do.
You could link the Discord if you want.
I should probably do that at some point. Buy my book.
Yeah, Skuro winner 3, isn't he? He's trying to be the first double winner ever.
He would be the first coach to win twice. Though, I think he might be the first coach to make it. No, he's not the first coach to make it to 2 shit hair bowls. That was Bullpees, who did it in losing efforts in seasons 2 and 3. He got smashed up by Try and then smashed up by Skuro with humans twice. Smashed up by Chorus and then smashed up by Necro. Back when EU was so bad that we had to send NA coaches from the EUFC, from the EU conference to the Shit Hair Bowl.
Well, I mean, somehow Skuro got away with that, didn't he? There was the blitz, there was loads of pressure for the whole drive. He did well to come out of it 1-0 down, to be fair.
Yeah. And, I mean, again, Skuro's very happy for the game to go to OT if he can get these bribes to actually be used ever.
Yes,
and
you'd like to do
stuff.
Some damage. You'd like to do some damage this game. Kadir Nick representing the North American nation of Australia. Don't re-roll it, Scuro. Good lad.
I think I would have liked to have just done that with Russell, even though Russell is a player that has a skill. I don't think I care too much about zombie skills. But then again, he just won a 9 on like 2 blocks with a zombie, so maybe Russell's a skill he should care about.
Yeah. Oh, I don't like not doing that from an angle. He could have done that from the angle. I mean, that is a pretty basic, I wouldn't say mistake, but he could have hit him from the angle, and then he could have pushed him into the the down guy, and then he wouldn't have given away the free block, would he?
Mm-hmm.
He couldn't have chained away the mummy, of course, with Stand Firm, but he could have at least not given up the free block by blocking a different angle.
Yeah.
And he still fails the stand up.
Freeze picking up right where it left off. It is nothing if not consistent. Like a metronome.
I can't wait to see that. I can't wait to see the stats after the game for this tree. That is ridiculous. But Scura's got to want to do some damage soon, hasn't he? This has got to be a little bit frustrating for him here.
It is giving up a block, but it's a relatively safe block with dodge, effectively blodge against a the zombie has no skills. That is a cage location.
Oof. So Scuro volunteering for the for the absolute aggro this half. Wow.
Yeah, still Invictus brings up that the tree hasn't moved, it's in the same square, and I think that's correct. I think it's spent like 9 turns now in this one square.
Wow. Wow, I mean, I guess this is one way of doing it, right? This is inviting a whole ton of pressure, but he survived it last time. And this time he's under pressure, but 10 squares further up the field.
Herp derp, base.
I don't like it, though. He has to reinforce where the tackler is, and he hasn't.
Acing award answer with tackle. Surely that just gets the Mighty Blow guard guy hit, and then the ghoul blitzed.
I mean, he could get the ball blitz pretty easily, couldn't he? All sorts of options for calcium.
Tree standing up here, if the tree finally clutches out a stand up here, that'd be pretty funny. Like, finally, Scuro bases it on it, bases it on it, and the tree finally stands up.
Nope. Yeah, he could have even maybe chained. He could either sidestep makes it hard to chain anything. But there's lots of options for calcium here. Right, I'm gonna make a cup of tea because I'm really flagging now. Which will be right back. Il faut s'approcher jusqu'à sentir la laine de l'adversaire et voir les insectes coller entre ses dents.
Say the tree is suspect. I'm not sure what else that could be, or what could be disguised as. Creature that is just a tree. So I don't, because I don't know what else it could be. Not an ogre, not a croxagore. Maybe secretly a troll. I know teammates next to him. And here comes the calcium wendies. Seems very simple here to generate 2 dice on that, multiple 2 dice blocks on that ward answer. So he has 4 rerolls, and that was a leader reroll, so I can understand using it. But also OT format, and the leader is pretty useful. In fact, I'd even argue it might have been valuable to not field the leader on defense at all, keep him off the field, and guarantee the leader reroll for a potential overtime. But that might have been the better play there. Rampant has break tackle. If this tree had break tackle, I think we would have seen it by now with how aggressive Kalsim is at cage diving, as we just saw. Off the ball, that's very polite. Yeah, I don't know if it's better to sidestep on the ball and stay on it and keep, like, harassing the ball or to give up this two dice to tackle, because you're giving him a two dice to tackle probably anyway. So Scuro probably should have tried to stop him. So anyway, up the sport answer. It is the one player that Calcium has with tackle, so he's going to need to rely probably on his wrestle catcher doing things now, or just more leap 1Ds. Oh no. Turning into a very good turn for Scuro, who suddenly has two good elves and a terrible line elf off the field, and can kind of get the ball in a cage, though this isn't really a cage, it's just a... It's only kind of a cage. At some point, maybe this tree will stand up. Yeah, it's importantly not just elves are getting removed, it's actual real players, not just light elves. It's one of the better catchers and his best ward answer. Oh, it's happened. It's finally happened. The tree is standing up and is basing a zombie and a ghoul, and the ghoul will totally not dodge away at the end of this. At the end of his next turn. Ce joueur va se prendre un coup dessus et en dessous de la ceinture.
Well, my apologies for the mid-match teeing away. At least Squire Eldude is here.
So to quickly catch Jim up, so Kalsim did a one dice cage dive with his ward answer with tackle. It failed. He rolled a pushes, then a both down. He then got blitzed, took a sidestep, got blocked by block tackle, and got removed. The line up on the back got removed. So very exciting half of a turn.
Mm.
Oh, and the tree finally stood up.
Yeah, the tree finally stood up. Glorious.
So something I said before all the insanity happened, I want to get your opinion on it. Should Kalsim have kept, since he apparently has a spare player, should he have kept the leader, a thrower, off the field to guarantee a leader reroll for a potential overtime?
Yes. That's certainly an option, and yeah, I think that's a pretty good option. Yeah, I quite like that, actually. Also means he's got the throw for the one turn. It means he's got the reroll for the one turn guaranteed. It means he's got his throw for the one turn guaranteed. I think that's a great shout to keep off the thrower. So, yes.
I mean, he is also the dodge sure hands recovery, though.
Yeah.
With that, Kalsim was playing passively on defense immediately. I say that as he went in for an immediate one dice tackle, because... Yeah. And instantly re-rolled. He rolled a push and instantly re-rolled into a both down. So,
yeah, it's tough, isn't it? It's tough because he's not going to get great shots at the ball. So I think playing very passively. I think maybe he should have played super passively on defense. And then, you know, he's 50-50. Just wins if he wins the toss, right? If he's still got a team, he just wins if he wins the toss. Plus, if he scores the one turn, he wins. So he's got pretty good win states right now, Kalsim.
I kind of don't like moving that zombie so early. I think I want to save the zombie until after this block to see if I can get a foul onto that Dauntless Wrestle Catcher, who's the best sacker Calcium has left. Adolus wrestling catcher is very seriously one of the best threats Calcium has to hit the ball.
Yep.
With sure hands.
But then on the other hand, he needs that. Well, I guess he could have moved the other zombie, couldn't he? The other zombie could have been the cage corner, and then he could have made that dodge to shore it up. He could still just foul the goal, right? Okay, it's only a one assist foul, but he could still do it if he wanted. He could dodge the wrestler and go for the foul of the wrestler.
Yeah, I also would have much preferred to hit the guy with kick than hit the guy with dodge with that ghoul, since the guy with dodge was already on the was on tackle and on the mummy, so it didn't have a block to give anyway. And that frees up assists by getting the kick guy off.
Yeah, removed, but not permanently, isn't it? That's the thing. So at the moment, you've got to say if Carlson wins the toss, he just wins the match in overtime. The best case scenario for Scurio is overtime. And even then, half the time, he just loses.
if you're a Scuro, it is a very safe assumption that, or I would be assuming as him, that at least two of those goals are going to come back before the start of what looks like overtime. This looks like Scuro is just playing for OT here. This is not a quick score to try and get another one. This is just playing for OT.
No, he simply can't, can he, against Elves? That is all he can do is play for the overtime.
Maybe he could have tried to be in scoring range next turn to, like, threaten, but I don't think it was a reasonable thing. I don't think Calcium would have been wise to even buy into that threat.
He can't. He can't even do it, because he's just hanging the ghoul out to dry. And, like, he definitely doesn't want to disconnect his guards, like, you know, his white, so there's just nothing. He could have had a zombie scoring threat, but...
He does have a ghoul in scoring range, but it's the block tackle that's stuck in the middle there, Also, this is why fouling would have been good, because it makes the screen a lot harder to do.
Yeah, that's Scuro. He's paid for two bribes and hasn't used any of them. Hasn't fouled the entire match yet, has he? Turn 13, hasn't made one foul. Well, at least he's not afraid to jam in the players for the base cage here, so you can do some very aggressive basing, maybe.
Well, I mean, the Wood Elves have no mobile guard. It's very hard for them to punch back, and you have two mummies, so I think aggressive basing is the right play here.
Yeah. He doesn't follow, though. Oh, he's going to come back.
Like that?
I prefer to blitz the dodger, to be honest. Then he could have got in both sides. This is, like, not good.
With the dodger with mighty blow tackle, you mean?
Yeah, the dodger in the middle, because then he gets to put, you know, then he gets to put the mummies in on both sides then, doesn't he? So he's like basing like everybody then, whereas this way he's only attacking like three players. He could have been attacking five players.
That isn't a very aggressive ball carrier base, to say the least.
It is, yes. But, you know, he can't uphill him, so...
Yeah.
He knows he can't uphill him, so it's fine. I really, it's a weird Wood Elf team that just has, like, hardly any way to get the ball, isn't it? He's got no guard, and no guard at all against this team is pretty ropey, and he's got the tacklers off. He's only got strip.
Calcium's primary opponents this season were Chorfs, Norse, Nurgle, and Dark Elves. So I can see prioritizing Strip over Tackle, because Dark Elves are the one team that has a lot of dodge that you're really worried about. And then on the other side that he was concerned, he saw a lot of Necro, Humans, Undead, Dwarves, and Lizards. So again, Strip ball's pretty solid against those choices.
So, yeah. I'd still go tackle, but yeah, it's true that, like, this is a blodge step sure hands is pretty much a nightmare anyway, but particularly for this, like, if his mighty blow dancer had survived and got tackle and everything, he might have even started mighty blow tackle. So if he had mighty blow tackle, it'd be a lot different.
Yeah, he just had mighty blow. If you have a double, the rules are stated as such that if you have normal skills, you can have two on a single player. If you have doubles, you can only have one.
Right.
So,
Well, I'm sure he would have taken tackle as soon as possible on that guy.
Yeah, yeah. That's Mighty Blow Tackle is effectively the kill stack in this league. So, with Orc Mighty Blow Tackle Claw. So werewolves, which as everyone knows, werewolves instantly good the moment you put Mighty Blow on them. No one has ever rage quit a league after having two Mighty Blow Claw werewolves. It's never happened.
Nope, that hasn't happened. Nah, well, it wasn't. It wasn't anything to do with the team. It was just playing in leagues. You know.
Has this tree moved at all?
No, I don't.
I think the tree maybe followed up a block one turn. Maybe one turn it followed up a block.
Maybe, yeah, maybe. Trees in my yard haven't moved in years, but very good. To be fair, yes, I did quit SFL, but it wasn't a rage quit or anything this time. It was just, I just quit all the leagues I was in, so I'm not going to play in any leagues ever again. I've learned my lesson.
So I want you to clip that. That seems like a proper gym guarantee.
It is. It's not even a gym guarantee. It's just a real guarantee. Why would I play in a league? Doesn't make any sense, does it? Like I quit Fumble. The day that I quit Fumble was over scheduling in majors. It was just a nightmare. And then scheduling in leagues is crap. Building your team up for ages just to lose it in one game is crap. It's just crap, isn't it? At least if you lose a CCL team, then so what? He's made a foul! Turn 14! Woo!
I will say, to shamelessly plug the SFL, one of the reasons that I enjoy it is I don't like Eternal Leagues, and so I enjoy the soft reset at the end of every season, so I can focus more on just playing the team for wins than building some theoretical optimized team that just is never ever going to happen, really.
Yeah. No, I did like that about the SFL as well, yeah. But then, I still quit.
I know OFL tries to do something similar, and Blua tries to do a bunch of different stuff every season, and those are all the leagues that I've been more interested in. But I do recognize that I'm also in the minority, that I really, really hate Eternal Leagues. And that is obviously a minority opinion, based on how many people absolutely love them. So.
No, yeah, I've always hated them, to be honest. Like, the leagues like Rebel. You know, the tiered Eternal Leagues like that. I've always hated them. I hate this reroll as well.
This... I don't know what the... What was he? Was he trying to get a one dice on the ball here, it looks like, again?
Maybe.
One dice.
Yeah, I guess that was it. Dodge that out and then leap in for a 1D.
Leap in the back, push up, and then maybe hit the ball onto, like, diving tackle again.
Oh god, but this is brutal. This is brutal, isn't it? Because now this is like a 3D from a mummy, 2D with tackle, 2D with tackle, 3D from a mummy. This is like, this could be a real painful turn for Calcium here.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he should have just dodged away his dodges. Yeah, I mean, maybe Jellyle with a redraft. That's the thing. We just don't know what it's going to be like on Blood Bowl 3, do we? And I think most people won't like the redraft, because most people do like these Eternal Leagues, that, you know, the tiered leagues. They are very, very popular.
We'll see how quickly people adopt them and whether or not the redraft rules are properly implemented. I'm not sure how I feel about the tax on having a returning player, though I understand why it's there. We've seen in this league that dwarves and dwarfs are pretty painful. They come in very, very, very lean at the start of a season. Though to be fair, we also have a that makes them slightly less bad is that you don't get a carryover non-leveled leveling SPP.
Yeah.
So that's a pretty big thing. And also you don't get as a BB2020 where you get a sit, you can't sit on SPP like you can in BB2020, right?
Yeah.
Which is a pretty big and very weird war. You can just carry over SPP and then not pay for skills, and then buy skills at the start of the new season. It's bizarre. I think a good rule change would be that at the start of an off season, you have to use all unspent SPP in some way, or as much as you can. I don't really like the idea of carrying over players that have this huge set of skills and then leveling them up on game one. That seems obviously exploitative.
Yeah, but then at least they've paid the tax.
They've paid the tax of the 20k, but not the tax of having two skills.
Yeah, no, I understand that, but the tax for the returning players does make a lot of sense, and obviously it stops you min-maxing with legends and stuff.
What a name. What a name, Calcium.
These nuts squirreled.
I would agree that Blood Bowl 2020 rules do not appear to work without, without redrafting, but I would also state that Blood Bowl, as it's currently written, doesn't work without Claw completely crushing high armor value teams, because in Eternal Leagues, but people seem to want to, remove Claw and not address the high armor value teams, so...
Yeah.
People don't always see how those things are connected.
Yeah.
To be fair, the new rules actually did address that you have to kind of weaken the higher value teams if you're going to weaken Claw by hitting lizards and orcs and necromantic.
Orcs were buffed.
Yeah, I guess all orcs were already underperforming, so it's fine. And then undead got worse, and then they left dwarves exactly the same. So.
Yep. C'est le moment de vérité. Hit the both down. Ah, no balls. If he survived, I think he should probably just run away now.
Yeah, running away seems pretty good here. Because you can't stop the score at this point, and you want to save players to give yourself a shot.
Yeah, and 1-0 fouls as well. That's big. He's managed to avoid the fouls this entire game. So, and if Skuro does foul, then he's 1-36 to just straight up lose anyway. Playtesting afternoon. Oh, Bezel. Bezel. Yeah, it is sort of building the 2020. Yeah, it's a weird one, isn't it? 2020.
Overall,
I don't think any of it was designed. I think that's the thing, people saying it wasn't designed to work without redraft. I just don't think it was designed to work, and the important thing is we just don't know what Cyanide are going to do with the implementation. So while people can say, leagues will be able to manage, they might not be able to, because you just don't know what there's going to be. They're just. Obviously, people would like there to be options, but if there aren't options, we're just going to be stuck with what those are, what it's like at launch, aren't we?
There's overall the majority of changes in Global 2020.
No, I won't give in
positive
until I'm victorious. And I will defend.
You can't say that uniformly.
We're
I think
lucky. It's
on the
even
whole,
as
there
good
are more good changes
really
than bad changes. But
yep. There's a touchdown. There's 1-1. Wolfbark, thank you very much for staying fantastic for 9 whole months. That's a human pregnancy, or just over 2 beaver pregnancies. We are lucky. It's even as good as it is. Yep. Yes, we are. Thank you very much, Wolfbark. Yeah, that's true, Tri. That is true, but it's just, it's just a little bit. You can't be on board with it. You can't be really pro Blood Bowl 3, because it's just all going to be down to how it's implemented, isn't it? You can't just look at Blood Bowl 2020 and know what it's going to be like, because we just don't know how they're going to implement it and what options they're going to be.
It's not even clear what Bowl 3 is even going to function like. I think there's a good amount of evidence based on the animations they've shown to hypothesize that it's just going to play exactly like Blood Bowl 2.
Mm-hmm.
Some different pitches and worse character models because, at least for me, most of the new Games Workshop models are pretty terrible and they've just photocopied them into the game.
Yep.
Noble models are some of the worst things GW has ever put out and will ever be seen on a level pitch.
I agree.
The Nurgle models are so atrocious.
Yep. They're using all the same. They're using the same animations. They're using the same logos. They're using some of the coaching staff are the same models, I believe. Also the models look crap, man. They showed a screenshot of like a high witch elf knocking over a chaos warrior, and it just looked super undetailed and just shit and wrong. Like, it looked terrible. It looked actively worse than Blood Bowl 2, so I'm a little bit perturbed by that.
And again, this isn't to say Blood Bowl 2's models are perfect. Ghouls are a little too small. Ulfurners are a little too small. There's some weird... Necromantic wolves' mouths don't, like, move. They look really weird when they just, like, hang open and their head moves. It's a very weird thing. They look like masks. But I do think they did a good job of having a pretty consistent style across the teams, and they're all pretty distinguishable and pretty appealing to look at most of the time. I honestly find the Nurgle team just unattractive to look at. And not in like, oh, it's Nurgle, it's gross, but more like, oh, I'm looking at a naked mole rat. Cool.
More like, who the fuck was paid to make this model?
I'm curious to what Calcium's play. It looks like he's going to go for... He can go for a POW and then blitz with the tree.
Yeah.
Or he can blitz with Dauntless as well. He also blitz with Dauntless if he fell up to that.
I mean, not really, though. It's got to be the tree.
Yeah, it's way too hard to do that. So I'm expecting the tree to fail, take root again. Oh my god. Hey, you know what? Fair is fair. Both coaches had this happen to them.
Yeah. Yep.
Calcium failed to capitalize, and Skuro's not going to have time to do anything other than like stop a one-turn attempt, so it looks like we are going to be heading to overtime.
Yep. And they definitely have the same animations, Jelly. You can see the Dragon Punch, Tiger Uppercut, whatever you call it.
The European Uppercut Shoulder Charge thing.
Yeah.
That they do. Like, it honestly looks like the wrestling European Uppercut where they bring their forearm under someone's chin when they rush under them.
Yeah.
You see a lot of players that were humans doing that, as they did in this game. It does look they've reused a couple of the animations. At least in their screenshots they've put out.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe they just reused them without reusing them. You know, maybe they just thought this looked good. Let's do that again. I guess, right? They could have done that, but it is sure that's how it works. Sure, that's how it works. I wonder if they could use... And I'm not saying that they're using the same code or anything, Jellyle, but they choose what it looks like. They definitely choose what it looks like when a block is made. So if they think, this looked cool when this blocked, let's animate it like that again. They could have animated it like that again, yeah. I'm not saying they have to reuse the assets, no, but you know, I'm sure they'll have reused as many assets as they absolutely. I'm sure they will have reused as many assets as they possibly could have. I'm sure of that. He gets the POW. Is this still on? It might be, just because of sidestep. Not with following. Oh no, it doesn't matter because he can't get in there.
Si l'une des deux équipes a une boîte secrète, il serait temps qu'elle s'en serve.
It was still on, yeah. It is still on. Yeah, he does the whole method now. Need to get this war answer out of the way.
Yeah, I'm not sure he can. I'm not sure he can get too forward though. Because he sidesteps to there. And then he blocks him and gets him to there, but then who makes the last block?
I think that's more interesting. I think the lineman at the bottom here makes the last block on the mummy.
No, I don't know.
I think that war dancer moved to the wrong square.
No, I don't think it mattered where he went to.
If the war dancer is so, replace the war dancer with that lineman.
No, there's no way. How do you get the last block? There's no way to hit from.
The lineman, yeah, the war dancer's in the wrong. So the war dancer should be to the right of the mummy, and then the lineman blocks the mummy up on the final turn, I think, with sidestep. Now, I guess that doesn't even work, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Oh, you use the lineman that's getting based by mummy up on the right side. That's what you do. The mummy with you use the lineman with kick as the final block. Because the ward answer doesn't need to be in that square. I don't think.
I think he fucked it up by following. If he hadn't followed, he could have sidestepped to there and then he could have got the final block, right? It was the follow from the catcher is when it went wrong. That was what went wrong. It was the follow from the catcher. If he hadn't followed, he could have done it.
Oh, yeah. Because the catcher doesn't follow, and then he blocks up. Yeah,
but there was no way he could do it from there. He definitely couldn't have done it from there.
There might have been a way to do it there, too. I still think that Warden's was just in the wrong square, but I'm not positive on that. I don't think it helped on any of the chain pushes.
Yeah, it was the catcher in the way. Right, wow. Oh, Calcium's lost the coin toss. And even if he'd won it, he didn't have that many players left.
And
he would have still won.
He's missing his sure feet catcher, who's moving 7, so he's just a worse catcher. And he's missing his. Importantly, though, he is missing his one player with tackle. It's kind of a big deal.
Yeah, all he's got is wrestle to hit the ball. But yeah, I mean, if he'd won the toss, he could have still just won this, couldn't he? But losing the toss, he's. He's in deep shit. Scuro's gonna be insufferable. Oh god. The only 2-time winner of the SFL.
Oof.
Oh no.
Well, good thing we have manual admin privileges on, so we can just force you guys to play it again or something. And skip to overtime. And not player two final play, not player two good player scouting, just stick him in a corner or whatever. I don't care.
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter. This game will get finished out and played fully. Or just force a game reset.
Nothing happened to him.
Yeah.
And his barely done anything.
Fantastic. Yeah. This is the one reason I made sure to have, as much as I hate doing manual admin validation, it makes it easy to just deny the validation and then explain calmly what people need to do so that people don't accidentally just hit, yes, it's fine, what?
Yeah. Oh, very good, Bessel.
You'll go in advance.
Try. You're gonna have to play an SFL again. You're gonna have to play an SFL to equal and then beat Scuro's record.
Scuro, having done it with both Necromantic and Undead, the most versatile coach compared to Trific's one-trick pony of playing Kimri, the one-trick pony of Kimri. Never seen anyone with lizards, only Kimri.
Yep, he's definitely a one trick. Definitely a one trick.
Yeah, but you beat me with Bark, so it's like you get like 1.5, maybe you discount it like by 50% for beating me my first. Yeah, you won with Chores because you diced me and rolled a million removals and then played humans. Come on. By diced. I gave up blocks to claw, and then I got removed. What an unfair game. What a shit game.
I said I was backing nuts.
Welcome to the SFL. We're always very organized. No one ever handles anything in public like this. Quite polite to each other. A bunch of coaches that all love Blood Bowl and don't hate in the game. Who could imagine a bunch of people who hate Blood Bowl would be bad at A, scheduling, B, signing up, or C, like, coach retention? It was an unforeseen turn of events.
Yeah, absolutely.
Impossible to predict.
It was still the one that I was most sad to quit, though, so, you know, there you go. But I just thought I had to do it.
I'm glad you were so sad you quit it twice.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry. I am sorry. It's, you know, out of all of the leagues I was in, that was the one I wanted to quit the least. But
Louis Clues.
I just had to. Bluey. No, you know what I mean. Like, obviously, I was happy to get out of all the leagues I was in, but, you know, I didn't even want to quit OFL despite the admins not being very happy with the admins and stuff. And, especially after I quit, it was pretty ridiculous, but, I didn't even want to quit that, but I just felt I had to.
It has been a uniquely poor season for SFL coaches quitting mid-season, with multiple long-time coaches continuing to play in other terrible leagues and quitting ours as a result because they couldn't handle Blood Bowl. I blame them. I blame those other leagues that will not actually be named for once.
Yes.
If we're going to do a bunch of shit talking behind people's backs, we'll just do it in our Discord, not on Jim's.
Thanks.
SFL Discord. Talk about everyone in Blood Bowl. One of the things that general chat became about. It's just a great place. Talk about how Jim is terrible. And now we don't do that as much. Only slightly less.
It's funny, that's what pretty much every Discord is like, isn't it? It's like, you know, the Diode Discord, there's a lot of shit talking, like Artemis and Lynn and stuff, and then, and then the SFL might shit talk somebody, and then I'm sure Sage's Discord will shit talk, well, probably just me, but still, etc, etc.
Yes. Pretty funny. And on the Davo Discord, Lady Killjoy posts Asian women. That sub channel isn't there anymore after it became very obviously just really creepy that someone just had like their own channel just to post people in lingerie.
Right. I'm sick of this fucking guy. This fucking Discord. All fucking day. Fuck off.
I will say, I think after this season, we will go back to having not only fewer EU coaches, which is pretty usual, though, which is the usual case. So usually we have... Usually we have more NA coaches. This season we actually have more EU coaches than NA.
Wow.
We're going to go back to having no EU admins, which has been a very funny thing, because considering Shawnee and Jim started the league. And no EU admins again. And then Artemis joined and failed the schedule, and people unironically are going to be an admin, and like in 2 weeks he left because of scheduling disputes, because it's a private league, so no matter what we do, scheduling disputes are going to be the most stupid drama in the history of Blood Bowl, always.
Yep.
I said I could play whenever, but not now. Every time. Play now?
Oh, the classic.
Cast now, Jim?
Classic play now. You've got to love it, haven't you? No, you don't have to love it. Looks like Skull's getting a massive foul in here, by the way. I kind of like keeping the Mighty Blow tackler deep, like in a way. He's got guard and he's got tackle, hasn't he? So he is pretty good at protecting the ball from untoward things.
Yeah, I think especially if you're concerned about having another blitz and getting all screwed up, especially in OT, I think it makes sense to have him just hang about in the backfield like this so he can be more reactive in the middle of the field. It was pretty insulting, Troy. Unfortunately, you had the bad luck of being born in the NA, and I actually was trying to get a coach in EU time zones to admin, so I didn't feel obliged to be awake at 6 a.m. to handle things.
And yeah, Bezel, it was pretty crazy that that was his approach to the scheduling. Yes. I agree. I'm an admin in SFL, I believe.
I believe in game you. I believe, yeah, in game. Well, I can't remove you as an admin, and Bezel can't remove you. J5 can't remove you as an admin. Only Shawnee can. And Shawnee basically shows up for, like, the regular season, loses in the first rounds of the playoffs, and then disappears for, like, a year, so. And I'm only partly joking.
I guess Calcium's going in here, dodge everyone through, and
the tree, because this has been the worst tree of all time.
Yep.
I mean, I think he played two seasons just now, Troy, so it's only a slight exaggeration, though it was true that he started the league in season one and then left in the middle after he lost in the playoffs, and so he scrambled around to figure it out. Yeah, it was, he played all of, failed the schedule a whole lot in the middle of this season, and then showed up and lost to FanFox in the first round of the playoffs. His failure to scheduling was so bad that he almost got a loss because I was so fed up with it against an opponent that didn't show up. The opponent had quit like earlier in the season and was already out, so he was just giving concession wins, and Shawnee had been so bad at scheduling he was at risk of just taking a loss against an opponent that wasn't available to play.
Brilliant.
It led to Calcium being very upset with scheduling for very reasonable reasons, as since he was here we could actually tell him to schedule, and yeah, and then he had to play against a chore team that hadn't faced any attrition for like 3 weeks, and he conceded, which technically meant Calcium should have been banned from the playoffs, but I just didn't care.
What are you playing at, man? Honestly. What are you even playing at?
Well, Jim, if you can do a 3+ dodge, just do a 3+ sleep instead.
Oh, dear me. Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Well, the good news is the ball.
Walked away for no reason.
Suicide Squad! Attack! Oh, fuck it! Fuck it. Oh, I can't swear, can I? Sorry.
No, you can't. It's all right.
You can't say the C word or other kinds of things.
You can't say the D word either.
Can't you? Bloody hell.
Which is dodge.
No. This tree, right? Seriously. Me and this tree are having words at the end of this game.
Yeah, it's something, isn't it? The tree has been one of the worst. I can't wait to see the dice log for the tree. It's going to be amazing.
To be honest, I think basing my game around the tree is probably not the best strategy ever. But, you know, I expected him to not roll nothing but ones, to be fair. You know, but...
Yeah.
This has been fun. I've actually really enjoyed this. The problem with me playing Wood Elves is... I actually want to see them die as much as I want to win with them. Yeah. I genuinely hate Wood Elves. And for some reason, I seem to play okay with them.
Yeah, that's a bit what it was like with my bloody Norse. Even if I won, I was still disappointed to see Norse win a match.
Looky Flack with absolute slander. I have never cursed in Jim's channel and in a way that made things awkward for him. I would never do that.
Yep.
Haha. Sidestep, bitch. Still got to suck up another couple, and I thought, you should have made the dodge, man.
That was fucking wild from Scuro, not just making the blockless block first. Like, fish for the power on the first chance.
Yeah,
he could have 2D'd and re-rolled it if he wanted.
Well, the good news is that if Scuro fails this, Calcium can then get a 2-dice with a player with no block. That'll be great.
Oh, I'm rolling pals for days here. I'm rolling pals for days. Seriously. Three.
He does fail. Didn't make the dodge. Didn't try for the dodge at all. Like, imagine if he tried for the dodge and failed it. It would have been fucked, wouldn't he? So I really kind of hate the blitz there.
So I've actually got a chance here, haven't I? This is probably my last chance. This is my last chance, but I got a chance.
There's this dirty player who has devastated Calcium's team by, failing 2-dice blocks and failing GFIs.
Is Kate in this game?
Those two bribes being in full effect.
He could foul the Russell Dauntless player on the ground, or he could do a GFI to base a player with dodge without tackle. So, not sure which of those two is better.
Yeah, I think you should have just not done this. I think that's the lesson we can all learn. Was to have just not done this.
Every player is a really bad
skill. Here comes the pal, baby. Le porteur risque le plagiat. Gucha!
Oh, he gets it! Oh boy, where's it gonna go? Is there gonna be a chance?
Don't catch it, you villain! Oh my god! For fuck's sake! Fuck off!
If only you had, Fumble Rusko. Oh no, it doesn't matter.
Oh, cough, Jim. Oh, shit in hell.
Well, at least you got the ball. He's still got to get the ball off you.
Yeah, that's true.
So
look at that. I'm just going to do some stupid elf shit now.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
All right. It'd be very disappointing when Calcium wins and we have our third champion in a row leave the following season.
Well, that's the thing. If I win, right? If I lose, I'm leaving, right? I'm going to sulk and I'm going to pick up my ball and go home. But if I win, I'm going to feel really bad about, winning and leaving. So McNaughton will never talk to me again, because we sort of made a suicide pact that we'd leave together, in glory.
Yeah, he gets the pack.
So, I'm going to go ahead and let you know, Calcium, McNaughton will not be joining next season. So, you are absolutely clear to leave.
One less grieving bastard to put up with, I guess. But. Oh, no, no! Actually, that's actually not horrific, is it? It is horrific. It's pretty fucking horrific. What am I saying?
That's fine. Instant 2D on the ball. I don't know if he's a dodge tackle. You have a dauntless guy with Russell. It's fine.
I've been in worse spots.
Yeah.
I don't know why he base the guy on the ground. Bro, base the line elf on the ground so he can't just instantly provide an assist and an instant 2D.
Instant 2D.
Instant.
Follow the money. Fuck's sake, Scuro.
Lucky pal fishing bastard. You're getting an insight into what I talk like during games of Blood Bowl now.
God. Oh man, no one's ever seen you stream, Calcium. No one knew you were.
Yeah, I know. Oh dear.
Oh boy, this could be real bad still for the only thing is no reroll. I mean, obviously Calcium should have one reroll right now. And completely spunked it for no reason whatsoever.
Fuck off, Captain Hindsight. Seriously.
Not Hindsight.
Recognizing it immediately. This 3-plus sleep would be bad to reroll. Rerolls it. That was bad.
What was that? It was just why even do it when he could have just dodged. That was the thing. No offense, Calcium, but that was...
Yeah, I know, you're right.
It was horrendous. It was
horrendous. Do I just go for the wrestle fucking double GFI suicide shot here?
We can't offer any advice, unfortunately.
Oh, what? Like Scuro hasn't been listening to your stream the whole frigging game and doing exactly what you've been saying. Seriously, come on. Holy shit. This is the best Scuro's played in his Blood Bowl career. Seriously. For God's sake. Ah, fuck it. Let's go for it.
Oh, dear me. Oh, shit! So near yet so far.
GGs, I think.
It's still unless some dice to roll, but yeah, if he gets a power on this hit, it's probably over. He's got just enough time, hasn't he? He's still got two rerolls.
All in the white makes it a little bit harder because those four squares of movement probably are going to be immune.
Yeah,
I
don't know
what
I got
sidestep
on manual. Holy shit.
Oh. I mean, it's still pretty elementary, isn't it?
Anyway, I'm actually becoming the Jimmy White of Blood Bowl Finals. I make loads, but I don't win any. So I've got this record to upkeep now. This is my third final, which I'm probably going to lose.
Yeah.
The other two were PS4 CCL finals, right, Calcium?
Yeah, they absolutely count. Okay, just saying.
Yeah, they absolutely count. It's like the 14-year-old karate championships, world championships, isn't it? It's the same.
I'm very proud of that. I'm very proud of that trophy, Jim. Just have you just letting you know, okay?
Yeah, mate. But you were 36 when you won it.
Yeah. That's some muscle definition you got there for a 14-year-old.
Calcium had a growth spurt like 20 years ago and it's just finally showing up. It's fine.
Yeah, this is looking
looking bad, isn't it? I'd just like to point out I'm not too proud to absolutely beat the shit out of a 14-year-old if it meant getting a trophy. just saying, you know.
I want to be clear. Calcium did not say earn a trophy. Just get one. You'll beat you up for a trophy,
even if you're not. Oh, man. Brilliant. Oh, wow. That extra play is going to help him when he gets his play sent off from all these fouls he's doing.
Fuck off, Jim. Not helping. Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy. God, I hate losing.
Yeah, it's shit, isn't it? I really hate it.
Nah, do you know what? Oh, there we go. Well, shit.
Oh, dear.
Ironically, I'd just like to say the playoffs have been a lot of fun. I think, as School Dude was rightly saying, the season was a bit of a cluster, you know what, you know, it was just...
I think we can say the F word was a complete clusterfuck and a shit show. It was really bad. Probably the worst season we've had in SFL ever with the amount of people that were dropping out. It was really rough, and I wasn't proactive enough in getting new people in. So yeah, it's really bad. Really bad.
Yeah, but the playoffs have been great. I got to admit, I'm, you know, obviously, you were great, Squirrel, especially when I sort of lost my shit a little bit with regards to scheduling that game that Flicky Flack tried to... squeeze the win out of, so I had to punish him for that. He got punished 4-1 for that. And then obviously facing Shawnee's full strength chorf team, it tilted me off the planet, you know. Oh, look, I've had admin results for my last three games and I'm absolutely full strength. Brilliant, awesome. So that was pretty rough. I don't know what you can do to make it better, because I love the flexibility of the SFL insofar as we're a bunch of guys that know each other and respect each other. So you really didn't want it to be rules laden, you know, like the likes of OCC and Rebel and stuff. So I don't quite know how you resolve it, but
Well, that's a choice, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. I guess never inviting Jim again, you know, because you know, the best two turns of his life. No, I joined Rebel in the hope of actually playing Jim one day in Division One. I joined SFL with the hope of playing Jim. Stop quitting leagues on me, Jim.
I'm sorry, it was just bad timing.
Yeah, no, do you know what? My recent experience with Division One for Rebel has been an absolute pile of crap. I've hated every minute of it. You know, be careful what you wish for. I spent ages trying to get to Division One, and now I'm there. It's an absolute pile of dog turd. It's awful. I want to go back to Division Two. I had fun there.
You might have got that if there'd been an double. I mean, okay, it didn't with a dice roll, but I mean, to leave such an easy uphill was pretty crazy. I thought from Scuro taking the board down instead of the pal, that was.
Still non-GFI scoring range, or does he need a GFI to score now?
He's out.
God, I think my dodge stats aren't amazing this game. I made quite a few in the first half. Do you know what? I think midway through the first half, when I got the blitz, I felt like I could have done a slightly better job. It was really weird because I came into this game thinking, for those about to die, we salute you. I just wanted to play ultra aggressive, you know, pretty much what I've done all season. Have some fun with them. And I found myself not thinking that was the best option. And so I probably went against the way I probably should have played. You know, when you change your mind in Blood Bowl, it can be pretty bad, can't it? You know, you decide to play a certain way and then suddenly you find yourself playing a different way. So I probably didn't play to my strengths, especially with Wood Elves. That being said, Scuro's been pretty solid here, you know. Other than making 1 in 9 blocks at the end of the first half, which was a bit daft.
Yeah, there's been the odd mistake on each side, but
yeah, and that happens, doesn't it? You know, it's you know, the role of a commentator is to point out those mistakes and point out what could have been done better, and that's absolutely fine. You know, I would never get angry with a commentator for doing that. You know, unless they use terms like unwritten agreement, of course, then I'm going to get pretty angry. I'm not pulling a Frankenstein anymore, Jim. I'm not going to call it pulling a Jimmy Fantastic because you didn't originate that particular sit back, protect your players maneuver. It was, no, you know, as far as I'm concerned, it was Frankenstein, wasn't it, on Fumble?
Yeah. I mean, look, to be fair, he did it without the intention of winning, whereas I did it with the intention to win, to be fair.
Like, as I did.
And I defended him instantly as well when he did it. I'm like, this is mental, because I think it's a good strategy. Yeah. Like, as soon as he got in trouble for it, I'm like, this is a valid fucking way to win. You can't have it all that way, because that way to play, because it's a fucking good way to play.
You know, oh, I'm sorry, Blood Bowl community. You wanted me to go toe-to-toe with a murder squad and die. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm disappointing you by actually playing smart. You know? So anyway, but it's fine. I'm not bitter about it at all, as you can tell. I really enjoyed that game. It's disappointing to have lost. Maybe I'll win a final one day, you know, so...
Maybe. Just make sure you keep entering on PS4 or Xbox and you'll win one eventually.
Right, okay, right. I'm actually, I'm 30th in CCL. Have you seen my CCL team right now?
No.
No. You need to have a look at my CCL team.
Look at it right after I see my fantasy football team. It'll be cool.
It's in PC, I may add. It's not a PS4 team, it's a PC team. I'm 30th. Look, I'm in qualification. This.
Look at this, though, the stand-up, 1 out of 7.
That's brutal, isn't it? That's
1 out of 7 brutal. 4 pluses. That's pretty
To be fair,
ridiculous.
It's better than you expected, but I think if you had not...
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to the stream. Your winner 5, your winner 3, your winner, or winner 2, whatever it was, your winner 35, Scuromezzo. Oh, thank you so much, guys, for that intro. Oh, it was so deserving of my mastery of the SFL. Thank you, everyone, so much for all of those kind words. I'm sure I should definitely watch the VOD after that one. Oh my god, legends will be told of this game, mostly about me, no offense, Calcium. I choose to be a humble victor, though. I'm just gonna come into this and just really enjoy getting a win. You know, just getting that win that everyone said could never be done, and then it got done twice, folks. Twice. I can talk for hours about this, but you know what? I want to leave it to you guys to talk about me and talk about how great I was. So, you know, I'm just gonna hand the mic back over to Jim now and say thank you all so much for your support. I know everyone was rooting for me.
Right, yeah. Thanks, Scuro. thank you very much, Squirrel Dude, for the league. Obviously, brilliant stuff running the league and that. Congratulations, Scuro. Commiserations, Calcium. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And stay fantastic.